I don't care if the real estate market's going to crash. I'm going to buy anyway. Hey, everybody. Scott Walters. Welcome to the show. If you're new, I want to thank you for coming. If you're returning, I want to thank you for your continued support. Before we get into today's red hot topic, let me politely ask you to give the video a like, subscribe to the channel, leave a comment below. I'd love to hear from you. Please watch to the end for my final thought. Hit the bell icon so you're notified when new videos are released. It's very important to stay close to the channel in these crazy, crazy real estate times. Crazy indeed. Welcome to the show. I hope you're all doing great. Buckle up and strap in. We got a hard hitter today. We're going to have another hard hitting real talk conversation. If you're new, please subscribe. Get on board. Get on board right away. It's really important you see a real estate agent licensed doing business in America that's willing to put your needs before their own. This is a hard one to find. I continue to see agents and loan officers alike in massive friends knocking at the door. But a lot of us, I talked to somebody today, they're like, I don't care if there's gonna be crash, I'm buying. Like, I'm all cash and I want to get my money out of the bank. Great, I get it. And let's just, we want to, now it becomes, where are we shopping? The only safety that you can find right now is certain markets in America. Where are you shopping? What's the price point? What's your risk tolerance? Now, if you're Daddy Warbucks, Elon Musk, you're the richest person in the world, who cares? But that's not the average Joe, is it? No, or Jane. Insane. Insanity. So today, I really want to let you know if, because I understand a lot of us, like, we've been waiting for a lot. We're sick of waiting. I was me, 2008 era. I remember the same thing, hearing grumblings of recession, housing market bubble. But as a trained salesman now, insane. I know. Once we make up our mind to buy, what are we doing? The sky could be falling. We buy. Once we make up our mind, it's really hard to change it. So now it's my job to at least try to protect you in this situation. Some areas are going to get slammed. Some areas might weather the storm. We don't know. Correction, recession, depression. We got to wait to see which one's delivered. Clearly, in the correction phases, prices have maxed out courtesy of interest rates. Now all we're just waiting on is some inventory, which eventually will come. It's just what's going to be the catalyst to deliver it. But today, if that's you, if you're like still out there looking, thinking, you want to get some money out of the bank, push it into a hard, tangible asset, smart, diversify yourself. Or just whatever the reason. Every case is different. That's why I always say, you see, as a real estate agent, I'm almost like part salesman, part therapist, because I really need to get to know everybody's situation. I ask some tough questions. I know a lot of you here at the show have talked to me, and I don't sugarcoat it. I ask tough questions that you'd probably only hear from a therapist. It's that level of expertise and involvement you want to hear. Now it's like most of us don't want some sugarcoating cheerleader asking us those questions, which they rarely do anyway. You got to get it from somebody you know and trust. And when I earn your trust, you're willing to answer those questions. So congratulations. But today, a subscriber sent a property. We're going to go and ask if they thought I should write an offer on this thing or not. But this one's pretty complicated in its own way. Let's go ahead and jump over, take a look at it, because I think we can shed some light on the situation. Then we're going to meet back here, wrap it up. Let's get started. All right, friends, let's go ahead and head over to today's featured property. We're in Norwalk, California. Now let's go ahead and see what's going on with their local real estate. Now let's take a peek around today's featured home. A single family home, looks pretty clean. Nothing special, but definitely a decent looking house. Now let's get in to the numbers. Today's 3-bedroom, 2-bath, almost 1,300 square foot home is listed for approximately $550,000. Now let's read a little bit of our property description. Welcome to Cabrillo Avenue. This original owner home has a vast open floor plan, upgraded copper plumbing, dual pane windows, and an additional sewer line in the rear of the home. Cabrillo Avenue is perfect for those who want to customize or personalize their living experience, as it needs a little TLC. Well, basically what they're telling us, it's an original owner and it's dated. Let's keep looking. After only one day on the market, it's garnished 5,000 views and over 500 saves. Clearly, this property has some interest. Today's property has an estimated mid-range value of approximately $575,000. They're currently on the market at $550,000, the lower end of its value range. Clearly, the seller is getting in front of this. They priced on the lower end of its value range for a reason. One, it doesn't look perfect, but two, area sales are starting to decline. This was the right move, as we've seen a bunch of interest in the property, but now let's see how it pencils out. If we were to give them their $550,000 asking price with a standard amount down at today's interest rate, our approximate cost to carry the property would be $3,500 to $3,600. Now let's see what its rent range is. All right, friends, and here you go. Its estimated rent range is $3,600 a month. If you could pick up this property for its list price, you might be doing okay. Let's get back to the studio so we can wrap this one up. All right, friends, welcome back. So there you go, and thank you to the subscribers who sent that in. So the reality is on this one, I like it. It's existing construction. I like that. It's original owner. I like that. It's dated, and believe it or not, I like that as well, because if it's just cosmetics, everything, like we get an inspection. I know that's something that we do actually normally. Get a general inspection. There's no glaring problems, no broken sewer lateral, no collapsing roof, no cracked foundation. It's just dated. I like that. I like that a lot. It's a blank canvas, and because it's in an existing neighborhood, it's insulated from any bubble buyers. The brand new FOMO factories that popped up in the crisis, those are going to be the concentration camps of foreclosure factories and festivals if and when those come. So I like it for that reason as well. Now, one of the things about this property, they priced it very aggressive. It's already garnishing a ton of interest. It could be inviting yet again another bidding war. Now the safety in the property is its price point. It's in the fives, the national average, what, fours? It's right within kind of the median national home price average. So that's always going to provide some safety. The extra layer of safety is it penciled out in terms of its cost to carry today's interest rate standard amount down at their asking prices, puts it within its rent range. That's just an insurance policy, even if it's not going to be an investment property, which eventually, hopefully, will be. But even if it's just your primary home, it's nice to know that a renter can go in and carry the property if something was ever to happen to us. We like that. So if I was the agent for this subscriber on this property, and if they reach out to get an assigned agent, this will be the case, is I would say, you know, let me call the seller side because they're getting a lot of interest. I just don't want to see you get into a bidding war. Luckily for this home, I don't think anybody's falling in love with it because it doesn't show perfectly like a FOMO factory staged and furnished to perfection under some think tank designed to get you to overpay for stuff. That's not this house. I kind of like that. But I would say, let me get a temperature check. We're going to see if we make sure we don't get into a bidding war, if we can get it in or around at that price that they're on the market at. Yeah, I'd say write them an offer and just be ready to walk away, because the type of interest it's garnishing, it's probably getting some offers. It's now to see if they've gotten you. That's where a good real estate agent with relationships. I know a lot of times we talk to real estate agents and you guys tell me, you're like, my agent doesn't want to hurt any feelings because they got to work with the, that is true. But a good salesperson knows how to get that information without being a jerk about it. Just honest, real talk. Hey, I got a client ready to ride on this thing. What kind of interest are you getting? Oh, you're getting tons, already over asking? Okay, cool, good luck. I mean, congratulations, we're on to our next. Oh, you really want to see our offer? Great, let's put it in writing, let's get it on over. Test the waters. That's as simple as it gets. It doesn't take a rocket scientist to figure this stuff out. And final thoughts, I come to you as a friend, as a content creator, somebody wants to see you not only win in real estate, win in life. Understand, the biggest artificially induced housing bubble ever produced in world history might not be able to sustain itself. If you're looking for areas that will sustain themselves, it's places like we looked at today and around this price range. And even if you get up or down from this price point, as long as your cost to carry today's interest rate, today's price, puts the payment within its rent range, no matter what you're doing, even if you're all cash, you want to know the safety of that house. You want to know the true value of a home? The true value. I mean the true value, not how much you love it, not the way it was staged, not the FOMO factory. What is somebody willing to pay you to rent the home? That's always the best measuring stick that you can use. And I'll be here to blow the lid off it every step of the way, because it's not only what we need, it's in fact what we deserve. If you appreciate the content and want to humbly ask you to give the video a like, subscribe to the channel, leave a comment. But I'd love to hear from you. Social media links in the description of this video if you'd like to contact me there, along with links to channels I've appeared on I think you might enjoy. If you need help buying or selling real estate here in America, I have the biggest network of top-rated agents in the nation ready to assist you. It'd be our honor and our privilege to do so. Email in the description for you as well. Also, if you're watching from your television set today and you enjoyed this video, you're going to love the next video. And there's an easy subscribe icon for your convenience as always. Thank you for your time. Please go make it count. I'll see you on the next video.